gusto lang, hindi pa kumakain. Nadami ng bukang bibig kung nakulong lang sa
40 new season awards in my career.
Silid, mikropo na lang pala ang kailangan. Lupang ako'y ladinlid. Ang dami, dami, daming maiingay din sa amin. Okay, tagal ko na nag-iikot para hanapin kung sinong sumusulat at tumihingang malalim. At ihilaw ang kanin to pag saan nagsasaing. Ang dami, dami, daming maiingay din sa amin.
And it's all happening in Minnesota from the Target Center in Minneapolis. The Wizards taking on the Timberwolves. For the Wizards, as we close out the first half of the season, they rank 10th in the East, looking to rally and improve that position going forward. Timberwolves, Wizards, the tip-off coming right after this. It's live coverage of the NBA on Monday night. Thank you for joining us here on 2K Sports. I'm Kevin Harlan alongside Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony. From the sideline, our Hall of Famer, David Aldridge. DA, take it away.
Thanks very much. Now, Commissioner Adam Silver is continuing to push for the creation of an in-season tournament. He says the notion is to steal a page from European soccer. It's not the Larry O'Brien trophy, but something secondary that teams care about. Something you'd see players go into that extra gear for. Kevin, back to you.
That's pretty intriguing, D.A. That's an interesting story, and we thank you for giving it to us. So a look at the starters for the Wizards. Morris and Beal are the guards. Avdija in at the small forward with Kuzma at power forward. And it's Porzingis in at the five down low. And for the Timberwolves, backcourt guards are Russell and Edwards. Anderson is out there with Rudy Gobert. And it's McDaniels at the small forward. A lot of focus on the guard matchup tonight, Greg. Both these teams rely on their backcourts to lead the way for them.
And if anything, it should make for an entertaining basketball game. And it becomes a little bit of a chess match when it's a backcourt duel. Those are always fun.
Over in the corner, Edwards for the three. Kuzma pulls it in. And it's Kuzma with the ball for the Washington Wizards. They couldn't put the pieces together, losing the last matchup with the Lakers.
Well, I felt like they were never on the same page defensively. And that one gave up way too many easy shots.
And, you know, that's all about effort. And I'm sure their coach let them have it for the lack thereof.
And a player opt-out for Kyle Kuzma after this season. GA probably hoping to earn himself a raise.
Yeah, and he's a worker looking to round out his game and take that next step as he's just entering his prime.
Last season, Clark, the Timberwolves snapped a three-year playoff drought.
An important milestone for this squad, Kevin. I mean, it shows they're ready to compete in the postseason. That's huge and speaks to just how far this team has come.
Now, here is Morris. Anthony Edwards unable to get his last shot to go in.
And they don't want to get in a habit of giving him open looks from three. First quarter still, but not who you want to leave open. Since being the first pick of the 2020 draft, Anthony Edwards has not disappointed.
I'll tell you something, partner. Timberwolves got that one right. Did they ever? I mean, we knew about his nuclear athleticism, but the leadership, the work ethic, the ability to impact winning also have been evident. This is a multi-time all-star going forward.
Now, here is Morris. Last game we saw him score 14. He gets that one.
No substitute for hustle and hard work, and Porzingis getting the bucket because he put both into effect there.
And there's Edwards on the assist by Russell.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
Well, this early, they should be showing a lot more energy on defense. It's not there.
Timberwolves have gone 1-3 for the field to start this one so far. And Edwards puts up a deep three. It's good on the putback.
And those second chance points really become almost like bonus points when you can get them.
For Washington, they've gone 2-6 from the field. Avdija, the pass to Porzingis. And the three off target.
You know what, though? Sometimes you can be too open. I think it may have surprised him, and that's why he missed.
Defense gets burned by Edwards' ball handling ability. I mean, this guy's athletic and can really move.
Now, here is Morris. Looking at his numbers, he averages a bit over 9 points a game.
Watch out now. When this guy gets into a rhythm, it is something to behold.
Here is Edwards. This one for three. Here's Anderson. Lays it up off the glass. Anderson's got his second best.
Really strong rebounding on the interior. He gets the easy putback.
So timeout called here, the first for Washington. Mark, when it comes to running the pick and roll, Monte Morris is more than capable, isn't he?
Yeah, Kevin, he's got such great feel and pace. See, that's what some young players don't understand. You can't go 100 miles an hour all the time. You got to play with pace as well as smarts. And he's got a really good feel for how to navigate those two areas well.
Now here's Beal. Right now he averages nearly 23 points a game, a relentless offensive force. Morris kicks to Kuzma. A rebound by the Timberwolves. They come into this one following a loss to the Thunder.
Yeah, I mean, they had their chances, competed deep into that game, but had a few lulls there that just kind of took them down.
And, you know, those are the kind of games that sting and that bad taste lingers. Knowing you were in it, but not coming through down the stretch, those are hard to get over sometimes.
And that was the Mobile One drive. Well worth a second look.
And you gotta love the impression that he had taking it to the rim there. Sets the tone in a close game like this one.
Ken Edwards puts up a deep three. Unable to get that one. And the Wizards now going the other way. And it's Beal in the corner. Fires the three. And the Wizards hit again from deep.
And that's money from Beal. He's so crafty at finding space in that deep corner.
Outside Edwards from downtown connects from three-point range. Edwards got 11 points.
The real come at us and we're coming right back at you.
A little back and forth from long range. I love it. That's a terrific answer there.
Porzingis can't hit.
Well, just not scoring with the efficiency he'd like to. Tough quarter for him.
Edwards against Beal. Edwards can't hit.
Well, he's much better than that. Really no excuse for missing that lay-in.
And here's Morris for three. Good. It's Beal picking up the assist. He has six.
And we continue to see Beal improve as a playmaker. Beautiful pass there.
So the Timberwolves called their first timeout. G.A., he's asked to carry a big-time scoring, but Bradley Beal makes his teammates better as well.
And that's an area, Kevin, he has really grown in. His playmaking, when the defense overcommits, you make them pay with the pass.
And the Wizards making a change here. Daniel Gafford's checked in for Porzingis. Hill comes in for Kyle Kuzma. Kispert's checked in for Avdija. And Barton subbed in for Morris. Wizards leading by three. Here's Barton. Gobert with the block.
And that's why you have Gobert on the floor. He's as good defensively as any big you will ever see.
Always good to get another look at a terrific defensive play.
And an early swat like that can really set the tone. Now the shooters will be feeling his presence.
Here's Gafford. Outside for Beal. And that's a foul called on Naz Reid. That is his first foul of the game.
Second team foul.
We've got 1:18 left to play in the first. Here's Beal, and the Wizards getting another bucket right there.
And it's clear how confident Beal is. The closer he gets, the more his eyes light up trying to score.
Now here's Rivers. Good on the triple.
It works well there. Not much resistance from the D.
Yeah, that's not the defense you need. You got to be tougher defensively.
Rivers against Beal. Over Rivers. True on the 14-footer. Beal's got 10 points in the game.
Guys, this has been an incredible performance this quarter. I mean, he's getting the ball where he likes it and wants it and just going to work.
Wizards leading by four. From the low block, Reed with the block. 8-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Launches it. And it's out of bounds. The Wizards will take it the other way. And so it's Beal who brings the ball up for the Wizards. Pass to Gafford. And Gafford throws it down.
Nice, unselfish passing there by Beal. He knows he can't do it all by himself.
And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. The Timberwolves shooting their third and fourth free throw shots of the night. The free throw drops for Rivers.
At the line for the Timberwolves.
He doesn't get the second one. Now Kispert. From outside, Reed with the block. Bradley Beal, he's been the guy making things happen for Washington. He got into double digits for the quarter with 10 points total. Back right after this. And if you're just joining us, we've played through one quarter in this one. Now let's take a moment to get your guys' take on the scoring so for the Wizards.
You know, right from the start, it seemed they got hot from three-point range, pulling apart the defense and racking up the points, too.
And I also have to bring up their passing game. They've been moving the ball with great precision so far and creating great looks for their teammates.
So this is how the floor looks for the Wizards starting the second. Kuzma will step in at the four, and Porzingis at center. Morris and Beal are the guard. And it's Kispert in at the three.
Corey. Boy, he makes it look so easy, doesn't he? Rising off the ground like that. Kuzma takes a lot of pride, not only in finishing with finesse, but power, too.
Right now, let's send it over to the sidelines and get a report from David Aldridge.
Thanks very much. Now, Kristaps Porzingis famously earned the nickname the Unicorn for his combination of size and skill. Former All-Star, injuries have held him back. But now a new team presents a new opportunity. KP says, I'm going to take my game to the next level because my body is going to be healthy, and that's it. Well, Kevin, let's hope so.
Absolutely. He has had injuries along the way, but the talent is obvious. David, thanks. And now, Greg, that we're into the meat of the season, are you seeing any emerging trends out there?
For a few years, the trend had been guys shooting from farther and farther out. But, Kevin, I think we're seeing a return of the big man, a more concerted effort to attack the interior.
Here's Kispert. Plays it up and makes it in. Kispert's got his first 2 points.
Boy, really solid passer at his position. Kuzma is all about doing what's best for the team.
Austin McDaniels back to Russell. McDaniels kicks to Russell. And here's Forbes from the arc. Washington with the rebound. Porzingis has got 4 rebounds now tonight. Beal gets a wide open hook. And it's off from 3-point range. The pass to Forbes. Beal with the steal. And here we go. Washington fast break. Forrest with the ball. He's getting his first free throw attempt of the night right now.
64%. So-so, probably wouldn't mind seeing it a little bit higher.
Boy, I tell you what, guys, hopefully it's not from lack of effort on his part. But his free throw shooting, compared to what he did last year, has been terrible.
Edwards has come in for Ben Forbes. Javier's checked in for the Wizards. Davis comes in for Beal.
And, you know, once Edwards flips that switch now, he stays fully engaged. His offensive arsenal is on full display.
You know, over the last couple of seasons, it feels like the Washington Wizards roster is in constant flux. I mean, from role players to all-stars, guys coming in and out.
Here's Morris. Anthony Edwards making his last shot.
Yeah, showing some strength in the paint there. Tough, tough people.
And Edwards with the stuff.
Boy, the athleticism of Edwards is something to behold. Love watching him sky up to throw it down.
Wizards have gone 3 of their first 5 shots to drop here in the second quarter. For Washington, how difficult, Greg, is it to win when your roster changes, as you were just talking about? It changes so much from year to year.
It's really tough. I mean, take Spencer Dinwiddie. You know, he signed the big 3-year deal, traded 6 months. shots later. So when things like that happen, it's so difficult to create chemistry.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
They double him with Russell. Here's Kuzma. The shot's good on the assist by Morris. Morris has got 4 assists now tonight.
The assist totals, Kevin, just continue to grow. They're way ahead in that category. Ball movement has been awesome.
Clearly just an example of a different mindset between these teams.
Washington making some changes. Daniel Gafford comes in for Porzingis. And it's Will Barton in for Morris. Time call here. The Wizards decide to talk it over.
And last year, Minnesota had a tough end to their season. In their 10th playoff appearance, they made their 9th first-round exit.
And a little under 3.5 minutes elapsed in the second quarter of play. Barton, wide open, he fires. A three-pointer is right on target. Barton's got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game. I don't think the Timberwolves, Greg, plan on letting their playoff statistics discourage them at all.
And that's kind of the beauty of this squad. They're out to make new franchise history. Not focusing on the past, just keep evolving as a team.
Here is Davis. Anthony Edwards making his last shot.
2 minutes.
Here's Kuzma.
2 minutes.
Second shot opportunity. Outside for Davis. Knocks down the step back, Jay.
And that's a great piece of work to get to the hoop there. Just tore the knee to shreds.
Left side, Edwards takes the three, and again, Minnesota with the triple.
And started hot, and he's only gotten hotter.
For Washington, they've drawn 7 of 11 from the field in the second quarter, and the foul called on Edwards. That's his first foul. Gill is checked in for Avdija. We've got 1:28 left in the second quarter. To the paint, here's Gafford, and Gafford throws it down.
And I've been impressed with the unselfishness, but also getting guys the ball where they can do something with it.
He is delivering a lot of room service times tonight. One sweet one after another.
And the three-pointers are starting to add up. That's his third of the quarter, and it brings him to 4 on the game.
Fires the three. Gets it to go from beyond the arc. Edwards got the lead up to 2 now for Minnesota. And a look at how the hustle game has been going for the Timberwolves.
Well, you know, they've been aggressive on the defensive end, and it's paying off on quite a few takeaways for them in the early going.
And how about also the ability to contest shots? They're staying attached and contesting and coming away with blocks as well. 12 straight points off of three-pointers, and the D looks just...
And guys, now that they're rolling from out there, the defense has to really get up into them. You've got to almost be in their jerseys to try to deny those looks.
Davis, the pass to Barton. Second chance shot. The rebound by Anderson. Anderson's got 7 rebounds in the game. And here's Edwards from the arc. And again, Minnesota with the triple.
And he's found his rhythm from deep, and you can see the confidence.
Yeah, I'd be confident too. As a matter of fact, I mean, if you're stacking up threes the way he is, I mean, he's doing all this work from behind you.
The Wizards shooting their 5th and 6th free throws of the game. And both free throws good for Davis. Outside, Edwards. That will count. And he got that one up in time, but doesn't go in. Anthony Edwards has been leading the charge for Minnesota, going on an absolute rampage, piling in the points. He dictated the pace of the entire quarter. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much. Bradley, good flow and good pace in the first half. Exactly the guys you want to play. What's going right?
Open looks and being aggressive. You're able to get to the basket a few times. The guys are knocking down open shots when we had the opportunity to. I mean, the shots are actually falling, so that's all it is.
They love to see it when your shots go in. Thanks, Bradley. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks for the great interview, David. And we'll be back for the third quarter of basketball following halftime.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show. Hey, everybody. Welcome back from the first half. Been a dandy so far. A dandy. You like that word, Kenny?
You know
it's
what?
A dandy.
My third grade teacher used to say that all the time.
That you're a dandy.
So this is a dandy of a class.
It is. And this is a dandy of a show. Ernie Johnson, Kenny the Jet, Shaquille O'Neal.
So what's a dandelion?
Well, basically, there was no stopping Anthony Edwards in the first half. His three-point stroke was a thing of beauty. He was very consistent, knocked down seven total, giving the defense nightmares out there. And, Kenny, what did you see out there from the Timberwolves?
Well, they were lighting it up from three, and that was the difference in the first half. They did a good job of running off screens, spotting up, and getting rid of the ball quickly. And their shot selection, solid.
And over to Shaq now, your take on the Wizards.
Their unselfishness has kept them in the game. It's put them in the system. Guys are making cuts. They move with the ball freely. They look to see the offense function like a well-oiled machine. Sort of like myself.
And that'll do it for us. The third quarter about to begin with Kevin Harlan standing by. We'll catch you on the flip side.
My brother.
And as we get into this third quarter, as we've seen so far, neither team able to create much separation on the scoreboard yet. You know, Anthony Edwards has been exceptional here, guys.
Well, he left his mark on that first half with his quick hands, great sense of timing to pile up the steal.
Well, I thought it was a great defensive performance for him so far. He's aware, he's alive, he's alert, quick to react to everything that's going on around him. Can't do it much better than that.
Driving in at the wing, it'll be Edwards and McDaniel. Rudy Gobert is out there with Anderson, and it's Russell in at the point. That's Chris Finch's five as we get into the second half.
And now in the final year of his contract, D'Angelo Russell trying to get back to that all-star level and the promise that got him that last four-year deal.
Here is Edwards, following the basket by Kyle Kuzma.
Really good job on the inside that time. I mean, he had to work for that rebound. He got it done.
Beal, the pass to Porzingis, and it's going to be out of bounds. The Wizards will retain possession. A moment now to hear from our sideline reporter, Hall of Famer, David Aldridge. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Wizards ownership has promised to never hit the hard reset button. We saw from teams in recent years like the Sixers. But the fact remains that this is a franchise that last enjoyed a 50-win season in 1979. So for the patient, diehard fans in the DMV, seems to wait for a true contender may take a lot longer. Kevin?
Well, time will tell, David. Thanks. Washington shooting their seventh and eighth attempts at the foul line tonight. And after a lackluster performance in last year's playoff, Russell has some making up to do.
Yeah, and the efficiency has been a problem. Now, if you're a player whose primary value is at the offensive end, you can't just be a volume scorer.
Oh, here is Edwards. He has 40. Here's the break. Kuzma with it. He's picked up by Russell. The open shot by Beal, and it's McDaniels with the rebound.
And they're 1 of 4 here to start the second half.
Edwards looking it over. A three ball. Rebounded by the Wizards. When this game is done, they'll be off to Chicago as they take on the Bulls. And that game will be game two of three straight on the road. And when people talk about defense, the term boxes and elbows comes up a lot. Great for our audience. Can you explain what that's about?
It's a great point, Kevin. And listen, the two defenders on what we call the boxes, that's down in the low post there. You see those two boxes down at the end of the free throw line. And then you have the two defenders on the elbow. So that's the edge of the free throw line. The idea is to close down the paint.
And the Wizards making a change here. Hills check in. First minute and a half of basketball here in the third quarter. Morris passes to Porzingis for the tie. The shot's good on the assist by Morris. Morris has got assist number 5 here tonight.
How about Porzingis showing us a little dexterity and fleet-footedness there? Love seeing him work that part of his game into his back.
And that was another look at the fantastic mobile one drive that happened a moment ago.
and the awareness of his footwork and body on that drive. Wow.
Now, here is Morris. After D'Angelo Russell's miss, on the out, the pass to Porzingis for Gobert. Gobert with the block, and he gets it back. Down to five on the shot clock. Here's Morris. Connects on the 17-footer. Morris has got 12 points in the game.
Boy, he's been a rock of offensive support so far. And when they've needed a basket, they've turned to him.
Gobert gets the bucket.
And not the same skinny guy he was when he entered the league. Gobert a lot less affected by contact these days.
Here's Porzingis. And a bit of a battle here for the ball. The official signals a jump ball here.
Jump ball.
So it's Minnesota now. And so it's Russell with it. He'll bring it up for the Timberwolves. 2022, Greg, a year for the Washington Wizards with some historic significance.
And it marks 25 years of the Washington Wizards' name being on an NBA jersey. A cool moment for the current players who can look back on this franchise and know they're a part of history.
You know, guys, whenever Russell attacks second chance opportunities like that, it's a big bonus.
Time called here. The Wizards decide to talk it over.
Things not going their way, and he wants to just try to talk this one over.
And you know what, guys? If for nothing else, just to slow things down a little bit, change it up somewhat.
Check in for Minnesota. And then for Washington, Daniel Gafford comes in for Porzingis. And Barton subbed in for Avdija. Here's Barton. And it's Rivers with the rebound.
Oh, that's terrific defense there. That's how you protect the rim.
And Gobert takes to Rivers. There's McDaniels. No good from outside. Wizards trail by four. Inside. And that's out of bounds. It was last touched by Gafford. So for the Wizards. Porzingis is checked in for Gill. Kisper comes in for Beal. Davis is subbed in for Morris. Second half here. We're just over 3.5 minutes into it. Over to the left wing. And here's Forbes from the arc. And he gets it back. Back to McDaniel. For three. The shot that time, not on target. And the Wizards now going the other way. Down low. Got that one, and the Minnesota lead has been cut down now to just 2 points with that basket from Kispert.
Outstanding execution. Good job working the ball inside.
Now here's Rivers. The Timberwolves secured a spot in the playoffs last season, Greg, and we enjoyed it after they got that emotional win in the play-in game in the Twin Cities over the Clippers. What a night.
And Kevin, you could tell it meant a lot to the players. This is a team that has struggled for so long, and by getting to the playoffs, it's a step in the right direction.
Good on both. Wizards trail by four, stolen by Rivers. And the officials into the backcourt violation, not working for there. Porzingis against Gobert. And Barton gets it to go on the assist by Porzingis. Barton's got five.
That's a terrific play and a good sign. This team needs Porzingis to facilitate as well as score the ball.
For three, Forbes. It's hauled in by Porzingis. Porzingis has got his seventh rebound here tonight. Here's Barton. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. Barton's got it all tied up now for the Wizards.
Very reliable scoring close to the basket. Barton's somebody you have to defend at all times.
Come on. And it's out of bounds. The Wizards will take it the other way. Ball.
Substitution for the Timberwolves. Kyle Anderson. Windows Moore.
Washington has gone 5 of 10 from downtown tonight. 50% exactly. Porzingis finds Barton. And Barton throws it down.
And this is where Barton does his eating. Deep inside, leaping with ease to punch it home.
Out to the right wing. There's Noel. Three-pointers off the mark. For Washington, they've gone 7-13 in the third quarter so far. Just above 50%.
Attacking in transition, the most consistent way to generate easy looks.
Yep, exactly. And if there's any opportunity for early offense, you've got to push it and push it every time.
Rivers, offensive rebound. Porzingis with the block.
Hey, with that length, Porzingis is always a threat to block shots. I mean, when he matches that length with really good energy and awareness, he can be a good defender.
And the crisp passing has opened things up for them offensively.
10 straight points off assist. That's very impressive. And it also makes the game easy and fun to watch.
And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line.
An improved free throw shooter compared to his earlier seasons. Nice to see Gobert attack his weakness.
Rudy Gobert taking two shots.
And he sinks the second. Davis surveying the floor. Off target with his three. Near the three-point line, it's Edwards. And it's good, but hold on. The officials may want to look at that one on the replay monitor. Well, we thought the third quarter was over, but it turns out the officials are going to review the play to see if he released the ball before the buzzer.
And to me, guys, it looks pretty clear-cut on the instant replay. I mean, the ball was out of his hands in time. I think they'll confirm this one pretty quickly.
Well, I can't see how they'd come to any other conclusion. I mean, we have a good look at it on the replay. The clock's still ticking when it left his fingertips.
And the call is going to be overturned. The second buck shows that he did, in fact, beat the clock.
Yeah, they're glad they're going to get those points. It wasn't too long ago that looked at it on the monitor, but replay's here, and it's here to stay for situations just like that one.
That concludes the third quarter. It continues to be an exciting neck-and-neck game. Wizards lead by three, and we'll get it going after this from the Target Center. And a chance right now to show you our State Farm assist of the game.
And I'm glad this was the pick because I love this pass. Such a great dish. That's what I call court vision.
Yeah, and with the accuracy to go along with that vision. I mean, he put the ball in the absolute perfect spot. That's how you orchestrate.
Tense quarters behind us. One more to go. Thanks for being with us as we begin the fourth. So on the floor for Washington. Morris and Beal are the guards. Kyle Kuzma is out there with Will Barton. And it's Gafford in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. Here is Edwards after the main shot from Bradley Beal. And slam dunk by Gobert.
He knows his job. Gobert is there to own the glass and cash in on as many second chance opportunities as he can.
Gafford, and he uses the glass on the layup.
Assisted.
And the Wizards Will lead by Barton. Five.
Nice pass here to set that basket up.
Russell passes to Gobert. For three, Edwards hits it from three-point range. Edwards got 45 points.
And he got loose from the three-point range in the first half and showing signs here that he's still got the flow in the second.
Russell finds Edwards. Washington with the rebound. Kuzma's got 9 rebounds in the game. Getting it done.
And they haven't been able to turn it into a big lead, but their rebound advantage is starting to add up.
Yeah, still close, but with their tough play on the boards, we're certainly seeing the effort.
And Kuzma slams it in.
Now, we've seen this video before, guys. Kuzma can take over games with his scoring. He's smart, he's tough, and he's relentless in exploiting defenses.
Minnesota calls timeout.
Adjustments are a part of the game, and that coach sees something he doesn't like here.
And you know what? We'll see what changes he makes coming out of this timeout.
Daniels is checked in for Noel. The Wizards also changing it up. Porzingis is checked in for Daniel Gafford. And it's Avdija in for Will Barton. And now the latest from our reporter David Aldridge.
Hey, guys, here's what Chris Finch went over with his guys during the break. He said, we're too concerned with their shooters right now. We've got to close off the inside. They are gutting us. Lead it with his guys. Come on, let's take a stand. Kevin?
Thank you, David.
Boy, you like to see Edwards doing work on the glass, hitting the boards there, using his strength and athleticism to extend plays.
Outside for Beal. Wizards working now with a new shot clock.
And you could see he knew exactly where that long rebound was coming off. Able to get there quickly and snatch it up.
The size, the change of pace, the shiftiness of Russell. A hard guy to defend without foul.
D'Angelo Russell, the second overall pick in 2015.
Yeah, pretty interesting too, Kevin, that the Lakers traded him after just his second season. It was basically a salary dump. It wasn't about talent because he's got plenty of that, but he was young when he came into the league. He had a reset at age 21 and then went on to rebuild his stock in Brooklyn, making an all-star game there. And by doing that, he showed everybody that he could start over.
He had 6 points from long range in the first half, but nothing's fallen here since.
Another miss by Minnesota. It's Porzingis with the ball. He'll bring it up for Washington. And again, Washington, no good. To the middle, here's Anderson. Good, and it's Russell picking up the assist. And the Timberwolves lead by 4.
Boy, the former second overall pick has really worked on his passing. That was an outstanding find by Russell.
Anderson with the double team. Here's Beal. They get the rebound, and the dunk by Porzingis.
Nothing soft about the putback there.
And why chance it, right? Take the dunk if you've got it.
Well, you know, if nobody's going to put a body on him, then that's going to be the result.
Oh, here is Edwards. Outside, Russell. Stolen by Avdija. Passes it to Beal. Second chance effort, and it's good on the layup. Beal's got the game tied up here for the Wizards.
Not shying away from the spotlight. Beal wanting to be the guy to come up big for his team. And those plays can make a difference in a game like this.
Well, you know it's going to fire up, Greg, everybody on that bench.
Making a statement for sure. I mean, we'll see if they can maintain that aggressive approach, guys.
Time called here. The Wizards decide to talk it over. Edwards with a strong contribution so far in this one.
He can't miss from deep. The defense has to regroup here, and I think they got to change things up because he's locked in from behind the arc.
We've played just over 3.5 minutes now in the fourth quarter. To the inside. And Kuzma slams it in.
Kyle Kuzma, a man you can trust in the clutch. Big spots, big shots.
And again, that gives him 51.
Making it look easy.
At every level, Edwards has been the go-to guy for his team. It's in his DNA.
I'm glad we got a chance to check out that fantastic drive one more time.
And a close game like this, you've got to dig deep and just find a way to make things happen.
Morris, no good.
Where you'll see him miss such an open look.
As we'll find Edwards. That's the 3-5. Rebound, Washington. Kuzma's got rebound number 10 tonight with that last one. Deal with it. But now by Anderson. The shot by Beal, no good.
The defense ready for him on that possession. They had to be because he is so strong in the paint.
It's tipped.
Upping his intensity on the defensive end. Love to see that. Kuzma uses his length and athleticism to challenge and offer shots.
First team foul.
Edwards against Beal. Softly touched in the fourth. Beal's got 6 in the quarter.
The That's a huge basket. Beal showing why you can build your friend.
Oh!
My goodness! And he is built to be the man for this team. Edwards answering the bell and executing.
And the burst of quickness on display with the Mobile One drive.
He's been a huge factor in this game, and drives like that show how valuable he is on the floor.
And now we'll get a perspective on the hustle game, how it's been going for Minnesota.
Really a great job in this one, forcing the issue defensively. Great quickness and discipline combined make the ball handlers very uncomfortable.
That's been all night long. And also dominating the offensive boards, and that's been winning them a lot of extra looks at the hoop.
On the inbound, Washington with the rebound.
You're not going to see that very often. Plenty of space, but he just, let's face it, he whiffs on that.
Yes! And he has brought them to within 2 points.
And you can't get a bigger bucket than that.
Well, that was one, two. He wanted the ball. Nobody else was taking that shot.
It counts!
Composed and cool effort from Edwards inside. Not rushing himself or forcing a bad shot. Taking what's available.
Time called here. The Wizards decide to talk it over. They're behind by four. 26 seconds left to play here in the fourth. Look here for Kuzma. Good. And he has brought them to within 2 points.
And we talk about clutch scorers all the time. He is clearly in that category.
Oh, I tell you what, he sure is. Defense is better smothering quick before he takes control of this thing.
And typically, he's reliable from the line. Let's see if Russell can come up here big for his team.
And they just stop the clock, so there's a foul.
Yeah, that's right. No other option but to foul and hope for some misses.
Yeah, they have to extend the game. I mean, plain and simple. Use every second you can on the clock here.
And a tough break as his second attempt at the line, no good.
No way to deny it. Coming down the stretch, Russell wants the ball in his hand. He wants to be the guy.
Morris, no good.
Having a hand up in your face makes such a difference to a shooter.
And, you know, he's a guy who knows how to defend the three-point shot. He's not going to just give it to you. He's going to make you earn it.
Drops the first one. That puts them up by five.
How about the work ethic of Anthony Edwards? Not to mention that linebacker build and the sweet shooting stroke. But what he wants most is to see his team succeed. That's what you love about AE.
And so Minnesota takes the win. It winds up for Grant right until the final seconds.
Yeah, and to do it, Kevin, what stood out is just the overall trust this group has in one another when it mattered most. Doing what had to be done and to send these fans home happy.
It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks very much, Rudy. This is a defense-first team. You picked it up in the second half. What changes did you make at the half?
I feel like we were focused in the first half defensively, and we just have to come back and communicate and just be focused, you know, and that's what we did.
Attention to detail, Rudy. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
David, thank you as always. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Greg Anthony, Clark Kellogg, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching the NBA on 2K Sports. See you later.